What's up, YouTube? So before we get started with this video, on GetUp, they're going to be talking to Ice Cube and ask him who does he think is going to go further next year, the LA Clippers or the LA Lakers? So see what they have to say about that.
What's your reaction just as a basketball fan to the craziness of this free agency that's happened this season?
I love it. You know, to me, that's what it's all about. You know, shaking it up a little bit. Yeah. You know, the Warriors have been so dominant. You know, for the last 5 years, it seemed like everybody at the start of the season is howling, Warriors, Warriors, Warriors. Not this year. You know, everybody's it's up in the air, and it's going to be great for fans to sit back and check out good basketball.
Ice Cube.
So you're definitely correct about that, Ice Cube. So the Golden State Warriors have definitely been holding it down for the West for the past couple years. And due to injury, they're probably not going to have as good a year next year because of injuries and the loss of Kevin Durant. But make no mistake about it, the Golden State Warriors are still a team to be reckoned with between DeAndre Russell, Klay Thompson, once he gets back from rehabbing, Steph Curry, and Draymond Green. Those boys are still competitors and definitely do not outcount the Golden State Warriors. So let's continue.
Is the Don Mega, and I have to tell you, your Lakers have not made the playoffs, as you know, in the last 6 years. However,
yeah, Jim, don't start tripping now. Dude. Don't start tripping.
To him,
you got LeBron James and Anthony Davis now.
Yeah,
what are your expectations?
Definitely making the playoffs for sure.
Let's start there.
Hey, better. But you know, going deep, we got a new team, new coach, new players. You know, you got to give them time to gel. You know, you can't expect them to win the championship this year, but you got to expect them to go deep. And they're gonna be all right. I ain't worried too much about the Lakers.
Okay, so.
So I'm kind of worried about the Lakers show because, like I said, this is the second year of LeBron James' 4-year contract, and they didn't even make the playoffs last year. And when you call yourself the GOAT and the best player in the NBA, and the best player definitely on the Lakers, I'm going to be expecting anything less than a championship is going to be no good. It's going to be no good, especially when you played in the East, and for the 8 or 9 years that you were there, you were able to make it to the playoffs, or you were able to make it to the finals. But your first year, you come out to the West, you can't even make the playoffs. Granted, he was injured, but still, you can't do enough to at least make it to the playoffs. So this is the type of pressure you get when you call yourself the GOAT. And now you have Anthony Davis with you and a couple other heads. So I'm definitely expecting you to at least get to the finals, if not win it all. And this is because you want to call yourself the GOAT. Well, you get all the pressure then, greatest of all time. So let's continue.
What do you have to say to some of these people that are like, oh, the Clippers are taking over Los Angeles?
In what universe?
I try to tell people, I lived in LA for 25 years. That's never going to happen.
It's never going to happen. You know, the Clippers haven't won in their franchise history. So until they do it.
Tell Marcellus that again.
Man, come on, Marcellus. Stop. Stop it. You know, but, you know, I see why they're happy.
Yeah.
But I've seen this movie before, and it's the same ending.
So, Mr. Cuba, I'm not too sure if you've seen this movie before with the Clippers. I'm pretty sure you've never seen this movie before with the Clippers. And definitely you haven't seen the ending. Because with Kawhi Leonard, Patrick Beverley, and Paul George, I don't think you've ever seen that movie before. Because I know I've never seen that movie before. And it looks like a good movie. And we definitely don't know how that's going to end. So I would definitely pay attention to the Clippers. Now, the Clippers won't, just because they win a game or two, even if they win a championship, they're not going to be taking over L.A. anytime soon. In order for the Clippers to take over L.A., they're going to have to win. It's going to take about 20 to 30 years for them to win because it's going to take multiple dynasties, which each dynasty winning 4 to 5 rings, like the Lakers have done. So this over that span, it's going to take about 20 to 30 years for them to take over. And it's going to have to be multiple dynasties, which each dynasty winning 4 or 5 rings for them to be able to take over and get on par with the Lakers. So let's continue.
It's the same ending.
Yes.
But they did add Kawhi.
Yes.
They did add Paul George.
Yep, great players.
Who do you feel like could go further this year between those two teams, Lakers and
Clippers? I'm going to say the Lakers for sure. Just because they've done it before as an organization. Mm-hmm. Clippers never done it. So until they do it, why should I be a believer?
Well, you might want to be a believer because of the people that they have. Just because the organization has a past of winning doesn't mean the players that they have now are going to win. No, I'm all for the Lakers. I want the Lakers to win. But it's kind of a toss-up because both of those teams look pretty good on paper. I mean, they look very, very good on paper. And one team has the defending champion, finals MVP. So, I mean, both of those teams look very good, and I would not make any bets right now on who was going to do what between the Lakers and the Clippers, because both of those guys look very, very good on paper, and the only way we're going to be able to find that out is with the showdown when they meet each other, and that's going to be an all-out war. So, let's continue.
I stick my neck out.
So, you do have a relationship with Magic Johnson, good friend of yours.
Yes.
What would you say about just the way that all that unfolded with what the Lakers ended up getting and how all of it played out?
Well, I guess it happened the way, you know, when they first got together, Rob and Magic, I was like, how is this going to work? So it kind of happened how I expected it to happen, that it,
really?
It wasn't going to work. You know, if Magic does something good, he has to share the success. And if he does something bad, it's all on Magic. So I didn't like that for him. And, you know, I want Magic to be Magic. When Magic can't be Magic, he's in the wrong spot. So, and that's even as the, you know, head of the Lakers or the head of player operations or whatever you want to call it. So, you know, I think it's the right move for both parties.
For those that don't know, give them a heads up about what's happening with the Big Three.
Oh,
I'm trying
man.
To make sure I'm at the game this Sunday to come represent.
Yeah.
I saw Joe Johnson trending the other day because
oh, yeah,
he was balling.
He's a problem. The Big Three, you know, Week four, when Providence, Rhode Island, at noon tomorrow, Brooklyn on Sunday. You know, great matchups. You know, guys going for it. You know, they starting to see. You know, you're gonna be out of the playoffs if you don't turn it around, or you know, you can actually win a chip if.